Right, it is a holiday. It's the 10th of October. Yes, Moi Day is back. I hope you enjoyed your holiday. Now, welcome to Y254 Entertainment Thursday right here. And you know Y254 is your favorite channel. And when we talk about Entertainment Thursday, we talk matters, trending topics, what has been happening in Nairobi and beyond. And I have a panel to do just that. They're going to be helping me break these stories down. But first things first, my name is Feline. You can find me across all social media pages at Feline Jean. And of course, the hashtag to get on is Y254 updates. Make sure you stay tuned at Y254 channel at Feline Jean. Keep talking to us and we might sample some of your comments and tweets at the end of these stories if time allows us, right? But first things first, let's meet my panel. I call them my co-hosts, starting with the Mwangis. Ooh, what's up? How are you doing? Happy Moi Day.
It's Moi Day. Merudi.
Maze.
Maziwa ni anyayo.
Maze.
Maziwa ni yoga.
Aflu. Sawa. Nyayo Kwanza, introduce yourself kindly.
Yo, I go by the name Dennis Mwangi. It's right. Always a pleasure kukua hapa to Jibambe. It's a Friday. Mm-hmm. And let's see what we have for you guys. See you in the show.
All right. And then we have the noisemaker.
Tawala Kenya, tawala, tawala Kenya, tawala. Raisi Moi, tawala Kenya, tawala. Do you remember those songs?
Of course.
Call me the only general of Fulimboko. Ivi tunanza Moide. Kama kawa, kama dawa.
All right. Sour, sour. And then we have our very own controversial superstar.
Since everybody has decided to become a baby. Mm-hmm. My name is MCK Official. With that double L at the end on all social media platforms.
All right. Now let's get started with our first story. Now, a Bangladeshi man forcibly shaved his wife's head after he found a human hair on the rice and milk breakfast his wife prepared for him, local police chief Sharia Khan told the AFP. He became very angry seeing the hair and blamed the wife. He then took a blade and forcibly shaved the head of the wife. The said man has since been arrested by the police, rights groups warned against violence against women was rising in the conservative Muslim nation. Khan said Bablu was charged with voluntarily causing grievous hurt, an offense that carries a maximum sentence of 14 years in jail. All right. So now you know, but ukinywa mtu bila yeye kutaka, how many years? 14. But that's not a story we're gonna talk about. We're gonna focus on Mwangis. Why will you shave your wife?
No, this guy, he realized the problem is the human hair.
Thank you.
Sasa mbona tuendelee na hii mashida ya human hair? Nyoa yote, the solution is there.
I can't believe it. So you agree. Where are you, mwanaume? There's a reason why women need hair. Yeah. You agree with the man?
Alifanya kitu mzuri, alitengeneza solution ya kwake nyumbani.
Na sasa ako kamiti huko kwao ya Bangladeshi.
Ah, by the way, it's not good kumfunga because yeye alifanya solution ya kwake nyumbani. Mm-hmm. He did not affect the state at any point.
Right.
He affected his wife. And the wife is his property.
Oh.
Umeona?
So tutafikiria hivyo juu ni Moi Day. Hivyo ndio tutaanza kufikiria. Tutaenda back to 1988.
No.
Sawa basi. Thank you. I appreciate your opinion.
Hata nizam support. Tujue uh-huh. Tukiangalia hii society ya saizi na hizi mahose hair, sijui cut hair, sijui ingine najiita nini, donkey hair, Brazilians. Nonsense. Tunapoteza pesa mingi sisi wanaume. Kununulia nyinyi wanawake especially.
Wewe ulinunulia nani?
Nani?
Pesa ya uli.
Okay, nasema nyinyi wanawake. Sijasema.
Sema, wow, sio nyinyi.
Oh.
I bought my own hair.
Okay.
I buy my own hair.
Stop, no,
if you're home and you think you bought my hair, uh-huh, get on the hashtag Y254 updates. Kuja hapo unianike useme vile ulinibaya nywele ili cost how much.
Lakini kitu mzuri in the society. Ndio, kitu mzuri in the society tunapunguza gharama. Kunywa mwanamke nywele hata kwa matanga tunanyoanga. Kwa sababu wenyewe kuna vitu zingine kisheria lazima tudondoe. Hauwezi weka na dread kwa matanga, tunatoa yote. So men, I think it's a high time Kenya,
no,
we should learn from there.
No, it's not actually Kenya. I think the reason why he was actually arrested, the Muslim culture, na kwanza I think au kwanza uko kwa India like Bangladesh, they take hair very seriously.
But
I think people shave when they are faced with calamities, I'm at old age or something.
Uh-huh.
But like it's like really, really valid. Like hair is everything.
But
you know what I say? Yeah.
Lakini feeling tukiangalia, nyule mademu mearaka, so tunapunguza gharama.
Please. Sasa ukinyoa sitamea bado na itaenda kwa chakula bado. So imagine mtu anyenywe limekutake 20 years ku grow. Do you know how long that will take you to get there?
Walinyoa na wembe ama na mashine?
Wembe.
Mtu wangu ndio mzuri yone kipara.
Wembe, wembe. All right, MCK.
Tunatoa gharama. I think all the men here today are tuko side boy.
Unguza mzigo.
It's okay. Unguza mzigo ni majama mwele zimetoka sijui wapi. Sijui kama ni maiti ilichukuliwa nywele kaletu alafu na vao na niwekea kwa chakula.
How?
No. You guys don't understand. That's all. You know, we are talking about shaving. We're not talking about alikuwa na nywele
atioi
yake. Yeye nyolewa nywele yake.
Ah, it doesn't count.
What's the problem?
It doesn't count. No, no.
That's it. Imeharibika.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Like it's only 14 years. Sana zambaya tu human hair rudishage hapo wanaga kiwa saa. That's too much.
Nywele yako
na
nywele yako.
14 years too much.
Alafu no, no, no. It's like, you know, that is ni kama unaona like someone forcing you to do something you don't want to. That is the reason why.
You will take your husband to jail because I'm a kushave.
Of course.
Ah,
hey, is everything.
Sijui kama unakumbuka.
Ulininyoa kani me like by force.
Men out there.
Men out there. Don't marry this woman.
Yeah.
This is calamity. This is problems.
I'm engaged in the latest scenario.
What? I know you very well.
You have made a very big mistake.
What do you know? Sema.
You have made a very big mistake. Take back your ring. Take back your ring. Hey.
Unakumbuka?
Opinion.
You remember going to school and then ukiona na nywele kubwa vile ulikuwa unafanyiwa makasi. Unataka kusema wale walimu walikuwa na makosa?
Lakini mwaiti alikuwa ananyolewa si madam. Anyway, let's move on to another story. Now the council. One meeting. Dennis Mwangi's one meeting. Let's go to another story. Hashtag YTF4 updates, right? Now the Council of Meru Elders Njuri Njeke has announced plans to regulate what is said to be high bride price demanded by in-laws. The elders say they are shocked that young men seeking hand of Meru women in marriage are being asked to pay as much as 1 million shillings in bride price. Bride price should never be the basis to prevent young men and women from getting lifetime partners, said Josphat Murangiri, Njuri Njeke's Secretary General, in charge of operations. All right, so Njuri Njeke, wamesema maze, you know? Mwangiz, what is going on? Maze wajua naitishwa mita. No way.
Wana imagine umetoka mita, alafu mtu akupikia chapati ngumu kuliko maisha yako.
Akurushia nywele kwa fundi.
I agree with this one. This Njuri Njeke. It's okay. We regulate because imefika mahali, you know, the problem has come that the economy has changed. Mm-hmm. Previously, ulikuwa unasikia, they say, I'm talking about the Kikuyu, but I'm sure they are close. Unasikia mbuzi, unaambia unafaa kutoa mbuzi tano. But now, unasikia wakisema, utoi mbuzi in mbuzi, unatoa in cash. Mbuzi hiyo time ilikuwa inatoka so. Saini thao sijui ngapi. Unatoa in cash. So, imagine.
Tuanzia hapu, tuendele.
So, 1,000 mzee, yes.
Use the mic, yeah.
So, imagine the value of that mbuzi, kitambo, and now. But you're forced to make it in money.
Yes, yeah, so what was said is actually, the council said, for instance, if you're told that to pay the bride price of 10 cows,
yes,
they'll have to calculate how much is one cow
now.
The cow yenye mnataka.
No.
How much is the cow now times 10? Because you know, like cow is 100k. So 100k times 10 is a million. Na bado nataka doju, na bado sijui kuna za macho, na bado kuna sijui zile za soda, sijui za nini. Maze, you know.
Ratio mara tatu.
So they're like, wait, hold up. We're going to have to do calculations. We need to regulate this. Like, I think yule mjaka na aliharibu. You remember there's another mjaka guy who married Luko Meru, sijui Range Rover, sijui 30 million, sijui. So, I think yule imeharibu biashara.
On the same point, what I know is that the greed for money is actually making things actually go out of hand.
Yeah.
Because, I don't know if it's true, I stand corrected on this one, but I understand, mtoidem, aizi bayiwa more than mamake. I stand corrected though. I see by your mother in some cultures. So utapata, it is simply because that he ameenda kumarika by that guy with the Range Rovers and everything, ameleta over to mob. That is actually underestimating your own, even your own parents in the traditions. Umeget.
All right, that is your opinion. Let's have half you. My opinion
is that kamati ya roho chafu.
But when do kamati ya roho chafu kwa hivyo?
Ni ukweli, mimi. Sisi kama entertainment thursday kamati ya roho chafu.
You are the fool.
Tunaomba mkosane. Kwa sababu hiyo mali yote, kama nimeleta ngombe karibu 10, please. Nataka ngombe zangu zirudi. Tukikosana tu hivi kule nimepeleka hiyo mahari njuri njeke mnilete yote mpaka ishe. Mm-hmm. Yeah, hiyo mchezo sitaki. Mm-hmm. Cause it's a high time you ladies itabidi yenyewe pia nyinyi hata mtusaidie pia nyinyi. Mm-hmm. Mmezidi. Eh, ukiona nyenye kama unataka ngombe 10 kwenyu, mm-hmm. leta 5 mimi nilete 5. Kama unanipenda.
Eh. By the way kuna story kayo nilisikia bishte fulani bishte yetu demu yake ali have kudanganya budake anataka kuanzisha biz John kwa members Joel was 5 million. Okay kwa ana do but budake alisha do mob. So akamwambia dad nataka kuanzisha biz nisaidie mita 5. Imagine alipatia chali yake akalipa mahari.
You see? You
so in Roma jilipia mahari.
If you want to marry this guy,
but I understand that mahari, unajua mahari si ati it's exchange, it's just like appreciation to the
parents. Then why ask
like,
so
thank
much?
Thank you so much for giving me a lifetime partner. You guys are making it like a transaction.
Philippe, you have a problem.
It's not a transaction.
That is
it's
what is happening with these people.
Check it. Philippe.
Nikama ase, wanajua, umtoi, ndototo moka nae.
Like, do you know how much they've spent? When muza shamba, muza ngombe, muza nini ndo usome.
But please, kiza, tuangalia hii generation zetu
kwa. Anyaza tupige sabu, ulienda chuo, I'm sure, haizi kuwa mesoma na more than 600k. Ah.
Mm-hmm.
Tupige sabu.
Alright.
Tupige pesa.
Wewe, let me tell you. Do you know how much? Do you know how much?
Let's be reasonable.
Do you know how much private universities cost?
I also did private. But ningekuwa dem surely. Sasa ndashinda mtaani kwa sababu mnaomba domo mlisha hiyo leo.
We actually getting the
well now that is when Jerry Njake comes in. Like you have to be reasonable. Like you understand?
I support
when
it.
Wanasema people need to be reasonable. Like your price ya marriage if iko like higher
yeah.
We actually getting things right. Wrong right, right. Now
because I'm not
marrying your parents. I'm marrying you.
We get it.
Unajikosea na kumbukana kumbukano zangu.
Sorry. Let's do this. Kamati ya entertainment Thursday. We're gonna do this. No, siro chafu. Hey. After this story, after news, tutaka biz.
Gapale tzi.
Maze na yu chai to discuss this story. But for now, we have to go to another story because of time. Now, police in Luwe Roin in Uganda are holding a man who claims to be the true son of God, Jesus Christ. And he was born of the spirit and not of man. Solomon Semakula, aka Elosam, Emmanuel Georgina. Prince Michael, was arrested on Monday evening together with three people at Kikabia village in Bumanika sub-county Luwero district. Police said he was acting weird, and one of the reasons given was that he owned everything in blue at his house, including the wall painting of his house. And his reason was, it is said that the sky is blue, so everything I own has to be blue. All right, so apparently Jesus came back na tuna habari.
Alirudia kijita sema kula.
I'm gonna take your opinions. Like, since we Yesu anavaa blue mazena kila kitu ni blue hadi sandals zake ni blue. Kuna mtu wa panel amevaa blue. Tuambie. Bure kunaenda aje? Hii blue. Ulijuaje?
Cheki, me I'm thinking these cops, unajua in the Bible, they say, Yesu atarudika mwizi. So walizuia hiyo kitu mapema, wakamshika before the wizi.
No, he's arrested.
Alright,
so I think Uganda people wenyewe kuna mtu zingine wenyewe. Okay, unajua society kila mtu sasa kichwa imewaka. So kuna mtu anaweza pata betri iko sawa lakini kuna mtu imekatika kabisa. Sasa huyu chali maybe alidhani anaweza sema ndio I reclaim ndio Jesus. Na Yesu amepata opportunity ame reclaim. Sasa amejulikana dunia mzima. Jesus ako area.
Sasa
kama umetenda dhambi, ona. Kama umetenda dhambi, sasa uko sorted.
Hawa Yesu ni wangapi? Siku nilikuwa tuna mwingine hapa na alikuwa
Kitengela. Na alitoboa. Sasa ni huyu wa Uganda. Na sasa mtasikia Kenya na kwa hapa nini Nairobi River.
We like we need to regulate our Yesu because as we know we only have one Jesus. It's our Jesus wengine.
No, have you ever seen Jesus? Philina, have you ever seen Jesus?
I believe there's Jesus.
You believe? So you yes, go to the Bible. Sindio, like in real story, how do Jesus come you? Sindio.
No,
so
I've never seen Jesus. No, I know he's there, but yeah. I've never seen him. I know he exists, but I've never seen him because I'm a Christian. Yeah, yeah, so
and
that's
Jesus
why.
Is there.
Of course, but I've never seen
him. Kwa hivyo hakuna dhambi sote tuko mbinguni. Because kama Jesus tu ameshikwa wote.
Wewe
unaanza kuwa ndani.
Na story yako sisi tumesema Yesu wako
ndani. No, sisi ameshikwa ndani Uganda.
MCK, you are a gospel artist. How does this sit with you?
I don't know. I think kwa jamaa kuna vile tu ameachilia. He needs counseling. Like who does that? Nimechikia di wife yake amekompelewa kupiga blue.
Ako na blue, ni luku.
Luku. I don't have words for him. I just don't have words for him. No comments.
Yeah.
No comment for
yeah,
him.
Yeah, I think, yeah.
The Jesus.
Yeah, pray. We
just pray. These are end times.
You pray. You don't ask questions.
So now my kanisa mekua mengi. Sasa Jesus otakuwa wengi. Sasa tundele hivyo.
Utasikia kuna association ya Jesus in posters.
Sida kunanga mtuse mamini shetani. Hakunanga mtuse maga. Hakunanga.
Alright, we're gonna do this. On that note, hold that thought. We're gonna do this. We're gonna take a very, very, very short break. And we're coming back with a new. So stay here, keep it white for guys. Please, 1 minute.
No, we are going to one of these issues.
Okay, we're gonna take a break right now. We're coming back as we discuss what you guys are talking about. Alright.
Y254. Imagine.